a series, this is a sequence, right? This is a sequence, what? Converges to what number? Zero, right? Not the sequence, but the, what's this? Series, okay? N from 1 to infinity, 1 over N, okay? The first few terms are what? 1 plus 1/2 plus 1/3 plus and so on, right? There is a special name for this. This is what you call the harmonic series, okay? Very important, we will use the harmonic series a lot, okay, in chapter 11, okay? And we want to show that this harmonic series is actually a, what's it?
Divergent
series, okay? So let's prove that, that's going to be a divergent series. You group the terms as follows, okay? So you have 1 plus 1/2 plus 1/3 plus 1/4 plus 1/5 plus 1/6 plus 1/7 plus 1/8, okay?
Whoa.
What do you think the next group will have for
eight.
Its terms? Now you'll have 8 terms. So if you have 8 terms, where will we end?
16,
okay? And so on and so forth. So if the next one is 1 over 17, it will end with what? Now you'll have how many terms
32.
In the next? 16 terms, so you will have 31 over 32. Are you guys okay? Right? Many terms as the preceding group. Well, except for the 1, right? Okay? Note 2, okay? If you look at 1/3 plus 1/4, so therefore this will be bigger than a fourth plus a fourth, right? What did I do?
Yeah.
Not me, but
it's
going
middle.
To be a half, right? Okay? Correct?
Yes.
We're looking at the behavior of each group. Now, what about a fifth plus a sixth plus a seventh plus an eighth? What do you think I will change the denominator to?
1/6.
1/8, right?
Yeah.
If I replace each guy by 1/8, are you convinced that the greater than holds?
Yes. Yeah.
Right? Okay? An 8 plus an 8 plus an 8 plus an 8. And what's that? 4/8, which is also a half, right? The next group, 1/9 plus 1/10 plus 1 over 16. What do you think my denominator will be this time? Change each of these to 1/16, right? And how? That's also a
half.
Follow so far? Okay. Therefore, what this means is, let's see. If you have the sum, you know, you're looking at the sequence of partial sums, right? S1, S2, S3, S4, right? If you're adding 1 plus 1/2 plus 1/3 plus 1/4, what partial sum is that? If you're adding all the way to 1/4, which S is that?
S4,
right? With this kind of thing, then that means to say that S4, which is 1 plus 1/2 plus 1/3 plus 1/4, will have to be what?
Greater than a half.
Greater than 1 plus a half, right? Plus a half, correct?
What the?
again, correct?
Right.
Right?
Oh, okay.
So then this will have to be greater than 1 plus a half, the first two terms, right? And these last two, we said was greater than a half, so we have this. Correct? Correct? So how much is 1 plus a half plus a half? Well, this is actually greater than 3 times a half. Okay? Okay? Bear with me, and we're going to look at some pattern here. So let's look at S. What's the next S that we have here? If we add them up all the way to 8, so that's S8, right? So S8 will be greater than what? S8 will be greater than, how much is this now? So then this will be greater than 4 times a half. Okay? That's what. So S4 is the sum of the first 4 terms, right? Correct?
Yes.
S4 is the sum of the first 4 terms. That is 1 plus a half plus this, right? But we were able to show that this is bigger than 1/2, correct? So therefore, S4 is bigger than 1 plus a half plus a half. Is that clear? Yes. So that's why this one is okay, right? Now don't ask me why they made it 3. I'm just teaching you what it's doing, okay? Eventually our goal is to establish a relationship between the n and whatever is happening here. We're trying to establish a pattern, all right? Are you agreed though that if I change this to 3 times 1 half, this guy has to be bigger than this?
Yes.
That means if I replace that as by a half, of course this is bigger than this one on the right side, correct?
Yes.
Okay? Now we go to S8. Let's look over here. What's S8? S8 will go all the way from 1 to here, right? Okay? So you're adding up all of these terms. So, but if you add up all of these terms, correct? And we were able to establish that this is greater than a half, right? And this is also greater than a half, correct? So therefore, the sum S8 will have to be bigger than 1 plus a half plus a half plus a half. Make sense?
Yes.
You see it now? All right? So that's why here, now instead of having a 1, they replace the 1 by a half, right? So this thing here has to be bigger than 4 times a half. Okay? Right? So S16, you have to add all the way up to, from 1 to 16, right? You see that? So how many halves do you need?
4.
So it will be the first two terms, 1 plus a half, right? Plus how many? The first half plus a half for this group, right? Plus another half for that group. So therefore, that's going to be greater than 5 times a half. Is that clear?
Yes.
So you're getting it now, right? Okay. And then it went on to show, sorry, this is crowded, by MI. What is MI?
Mathematical
induction. Can you conclude anything about what will happen to, what are 4, 8, 16? 4, 8, 16, then what's the next number that you're
using?
32, right? 4, 8, 16, 32, 64. What are those? Those are what? Powers of?
2.
Of 3, okay. Of 2, right? Okay. If you have S, 2 to the, let's look at 4. It's 2 to the what?
2.
2 squared. And this is 2 cubed. And this is 2 to the 4. So by mathematical induction, how do you write S? It used the letter K. S sub 2 to the K. Is there a pattern we can see? And that's why you'll see now, oh, maybe that's why they like 3, 4, 5. Anybody see what the pattern is?
Yes.
S sub 2 squared, S sub 2 squared is 3 times 1 half, right? Corresponds to 3 times 1 half. S sub 2 cubed, that's 3, right? Is 4.
Oh, so it's K plus 1.
S to the 2 to the 4th is 5, right?
K plus 1
plus
a half.
So by mathematical induction, we see that this sum is greater than what?
K plus
1 times a half. Okay? So far so good? So what? So now what? What was our goal?
Series of divergence. To find that number.
We want to see if this will convert, go to some number, right? Okay. Kevin said, well, what you want to do really is to see what happens to S sub n as time goes on, right? Correct?
Yes.
As n becomes large, in this case, it's 2 to the k, right? As this 2 to the k becomes large, because it's always bigger than k plus 1 times 1 half, right? As time goes on, what happens to this expression, k plus 1 times a half?
Infinity.
It just becomes big, right? It just becomes bigger and bigger and bigger. So therefore, what can you conclude about your series? You cannot approach a finite number, right? There is no finite sum, and therefore the harmonic series diverges. Is that clear? Oh, right. So you'll remember that forever, right?